I know a few weeks ago, maybe after the Stanford game, you were asked about, you know, this team still kind of picking up where Pat Summitt left off, but you said we got to beat those teams like the Stanfords and the Baylors. Mm-hmm. And so after what happened with Notre Dame, where's the team's mindset right now? You guys still encouraged, still confident?
Well, absolutely, we're confident. We understand that we're not there yet. We played a great Notre Dame team, and you know, we just made basic little mistakes. And so we're a very good team, and I think we consider ourselves to be very good. But to be great, we have to be more disciplined. We have to focus on the little things, like coming off screens, like jumping to the ball so they can't get 7 wide open layups or whatever it is. You know, those things are what's gonna take us over the edge and be able to, you know, compete and play and hopefully beat, you know, those top 4 teams.
Where do you feel like you're at on that transition from very good to great as a team, doing those little things?
I think we're kind of in the middle. I think we're continuing to understand the importance of that. I think we got the big things down, and now the little things, like I said, are really what take you over the top. And so I think we're continuing, and I think Notre Dame was a great show that, look, it wasn't the big things that killed us, it was just the little details. And so the good news is we're very motivated, and this group is very competitive, and so we want to be the best, and so we're going to do everything we can to possibly get there.
How discouraging is it when you see all these injuries, see Izzy go down, you know, and Sierra's still out? Is it discouraging at all?
It's not discouraging. Obviously, we feel awful for, you know, whoever goes out. And I mean, they're like our sisters, so you feel for them. And we know that we got their back and they got our back, and they're going to get back as soon as possible. But it's just the next person in line has got to step up. That's just how this team has always been. You know, that's how we recruit, where, you know, if somebody goes down or someone's in foul trouble, someone's just got to come in and, you know, take off the load and, you know, do the best possible.
You were able to make that comeback in the second half without Izzy, and she got hurt. How encouraging is that you're able to kind of hang with an elite team even after the injury?
Oh, it's very encouraging because, like I said, I think this team is more competitive and has more fight than any team I've been on here so far. And, you know, that's great. Even though we're young, we don't look at it that way. And so I think, you know, this team's never going to give up on anybody in any game. And, you know, we were right there. We were right there, and then those last, you know, 3 minutes, we just didn't capitalize and we didn't convert like we wanted to. But that's encouraging.
Taber, did Tamika speak to you guys after the game on Monday? If so, what was her general message to you guys?
Her general message was just, you can't have lulls. You know, even she saw it in shoot around where we had great energy for most of it, and then we'd get a little lull and then pick it back up and then kind of lull off. And that's more of a, it's not a physical thing. It's more of a mental thing, I think, right now. And with us being so young, you know, and this is 4 months into the season or whatever it is, you know, that's where the mind goes first. And so, you know, being able to tune into everything mentally and not having mental lapses is going to be huge.
Was it good hearing that from her? I imagine you probably hear something similar from the coaches, but hearing this team hearing that from her, did that make it somehow a different message at all, or maybe it resonates a little bit more?
I mean, possibly, just because, you know, we all look up to her. I mean, Tamika's kind of everybody's role model on this team, and, you know, when you come to Tennessee, everyone wants to strive to be like a Tamika Catchings, and who she was on the court, off the court, leadership-wise, hardworking, all that. And so, you know, when she goes up there and passionately speaks to us, it definitely resonates.
Was she pretty fired up?
Absolutely, yeah.
Was the timing of it good after a game like that, or after at a big moment like that, or not?
No, for sure. I mean, I think she uses her wisdom and her judgment on a lot of stuff, and, you know, we needed to not only be challenged, but we also need to be encouraged, and she did both. So I think that was perfect timing.
Mississippi State, know much? What do you know about them?
Well, they're very athletic. They're kind of out of the Alabama mold. A lot of drivers, don't run a ton of sets. They just really like to do one-on-ones and get to the basket, penetrate. They got, you know, A&M's assistant coach, which is like their defensive mind, basically. And so we know that they're going to be tough on that end, and we're just going to have to execute.
It's Holly's, you know, when she speaks with you, does she basically say, you know, her message, I don't care what happened in the past, you know, let's just at least finish the SEC strong and then we'll go from there. You know what I mean?
Well, absolutely. I mean, she's always just about just leave your heart on the court and just play hard, and you can't have regrets when you play hard and you leave everything out there. And I mean, obviously we're gonna have some technical things that we need to fix, and, you know, the little things like I said, but you know, she's proud of us if we just leave everything, and we believe, you know, if we do that, then we're gonna be right there in the thick of things.
Taber, could you jump ahead and talk a little bit about Sunday and going going home is, I mean, it's not home, but it sort of is. I mean, is it, what does this game mean to you? I mean, it wasn't, you couldn't have had this game last year.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, it was really an answer to prayer. I literally was praying that we'd go to Missouri this year, and it's just amazing. I mean, I'm going to have a ton of family there, and it just is really special to be my senior year, and the timing that Missouri came into the SEC, and it's going to be a tough game, great atmosphere, and I mean, they're shooters on their home court, and so that's always dangerous, and so we're going to have to be ready for them, but I'm really looking forward to that game.
Do you know about how many family members are going to be at that game?
Probably between 35 and 50 people.
Could you also talk about Graves and what kind of a year she's having? I mean, we talked about her early in the year, she established herself, but she's really been a real pretty consistent for a young player.
Oh, she's been fantastic for us. She's really been kind of that rock inside, and I mean, we relied a lot on Izzy and still are hopefully going to, but she's just been so consistent and just that workhorse. And I mean, her offense, she had 10 offensive rebounds or 11 against Notre Dame. And I mean, that's ridiculously awesome. And so, you know, she's going to have to carry a lot of load and, you know, log a lot of minutes. And we believe in her, and I think she's ready to do that.
Thanks.
Yep, absolutely. Thanks.